So as you can see, the one-story building, which is also the Citadel Hospital at Alajo in Accra, for now, it remains locked and almost abandoned. There are no security guards here. There are no BNI operatives. There are no police personnel. Unless, of course, we have plainclothes uniformed men, or plainclothes rather, officers who may be guarding this from vantage points. But what is important is that this facility here supposedly housed smuggled weapons, ammunition, and so on. And it was a subject of a raid on Friday by BNI operatives with support, we are told, from the military and the Ghana Police Service. The information is that the doctor who runs here, Dr. Pam, supposedly hoarded weapons, ammunition, and also had a blacksmith who was helping him. We're not sure the fine details because, as you would know, the BNI is always tight-lipped on information. But snippets of information suggest this gentleman who runs this hospital has been put in cuffs and whisked away on Friday. He is currently in detention. His family members, we are told, cannot reach him. We are going to move now and speak to shop owners who are all over this particular place. Hello, madam.
Hello.
My name is Umaru Sanda Amadu. I'm with City Newsroom on City TV. Can I know your name?
My name is Agnes Kwe.
Agnes Kwe. Were you here on Friday? What did you see?
Friday, in the one store, na Bunoni. In a Casa Guagbe, Tomo 4. I'm able to in a shark, I say. We're washing base, Kwe, German. Well, me poor in the machine crown in like a tunnel rebel be low, me feel ready. She had been a semiana soldier for a night here, Tony, or certain you were saying. Amen.
Well, the story about the arrest of Dr. Pam is developing fresh legs now because government has just issued a statement in which statement they are giving an elaborate design or plan by Dr. Pam and others to destabilize government. Very strong words coming from the government, which they say has been foiled by state security agencies over 15 months of investigations and collaboration between all the state agencies. They have actually eventually arrested these persons, and that statement has been put together by Minister for Information Kojo Ponkrum. I'm just going to discuss that statement quickly now because a parliamentary correspondent, Duke Mensah Opoku, has been studying. Duke, hello, welcome to City Newsroom.
Thank you, Sanda.
What is Kojo Ponkrum saying?
Well, it's essentially saying that the state, through the collaboration of some of its foremost security and intelligence organizations, that's Defense Intelligence, BNI, and the CID, have conducted an operation to essentially foil what could have been an operation targeted at toppling the government of this country to create political instability.
Now, if you use the services of, say, Uber, Yango, Bolt, and the other up-hailing services, next week you may not have these services. This is because the drivers who use these online app services are threatening to embark on a demonstration and also lay down their tools for 1 week. Why? They are protesting certain conditions around these apps. Give us in general what the critical issues are.
In fact, we have believed as at now to understand that these app operators like Uber, Taxify, Bolt, and the rest are using the drivers in Ghana as slave workers.
Why do you say that?
Because anybody that works have to benefit from the work. And then if you so that you can make a life. But these people are subduing us. We make nothing out of a 17-hour drive in a day. You still make nothing. These apps have come to give comfort. Comfort in the sense that a driver will drive to your doorsteps and pick you to where you are going, exact location and exact destination. They are turning the whole thing around to make the driver a slave worker. Why Ghanaians cannot protest against them is because they are using our own people against us. Look, we did not sign on to a situation where a driver will drive 10 minutes to pick somebody, for example, from Circle to East Legon, which a taxi driver would have charged like 30 to 40 cedis. Uber will charge like 21, 23 cedis. When you get there, Uber will tell you it's a promotion, free of charge. The rider should go. The driver took nothing from the person.
But they gave you incentives later for
that. They gave us no incentive. They are giving us no incentive.
And in some other stories, tension is mounting in Nkoranza following the installment of Kweku Soro as a chief, despite an ongoing mediation effort by the Asantehene. Now, our correspondent Michael Sapong Infum has more.
The Nkoranza Traditional Council in the Bunu East region is without a chief. Following the death of Okatachi Ajiman Kudom IV, the then paramount chief, 3 years ago, but the decision on who to succeed the late chief has become a problem, leading to the closure of the Nkoranza Chief's Palace. The Asantehene Otumfuo Asetutu II, who oversees the Nkoranza traditional area, has been trying to resolve the stalemate. It has thus come as a surprise that even before the chief settles the matter, a new chief has been installed, heightening tensions in the community. The Queen Mother of Nkoranza traditional area, Nana Kuda Kani II, addressing a press conference in Nkoranza, noted that the new chief, Kweku Soro, has not been endorsed by kingmakers in the traditional area, and therefore he cannot hold himself as a chief.